Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you? I hope you are well. I am also well by the grace of Almighty Allah. So, first of all, I would like to express my gratitude to the Almighty Allah for keeping us still safe and sound. Dear students, you know, regular online classes are going on following a routine. So, you should follow the routine and attend your classes regularly. If you attend the classes regularly and do your homework sincerely, it will help you to prepare yourself to meet any challenges of life, and then life will be enjoyable to you. So, dear students, don't waste your time, shake off your laziness and be sincere to your studies. Today I am here to take a class on English first paper for class 9. So get ready with your textbook, writing pad and other necessary things. Let's start the class. First of all, I would like to welcome you to my class. I am S. M. Munirujjaman, assistant teacher, Jashore Zilla School, Jashore. Dear students, here is a picture for you. Look at the picture. Look at the picture. Here is a building. Can you tell what is this building? What is this building? Is this a courthouse? Is this a dwelling place? Is this a public building? What is this building? I think you all know it. Perhaps many of you have visited it. This is a mosque. This is a mosque. A prayer house, a prayer house for the Muslims. The Muslims go to the mosque to say their prayers 5 times a day. So it's a mosque. Can you tell the name of this beautiful mosque? I think you can. This is Shat Gumbuz Mosque. So today we are going to learn about Shat Gumbuz Mosque. Our today's lesson is the Shat Gumbuz Mosque. So, dear students, open your text at Unit 8, Lesson on B. Our lesson title is the Shat Gumbuz Mosque, Subject English First Paper, Class 9. Before going through the text, I would like to tell you about the Shat Gumbuz Mosque, and this will help you to understand the text easily. Shat Gumbuz Mosque is a historical mosque. It bears the memory of Khan Jahan Ali. You know, Khan Jahan Ali came to the southern part of Bangladesh, that is, he came to Bagherhat in 15th century. Then Bagherhat was known as Kholipatabad. It was an inhospitable place. This place was not suitable for living. So after coming here, Khan Jahan Ali constructed a network of roads, bridges, public buildings, reservoirs to make the area fit for human habitation. And he also constructed many mosques. There were about 360 mosques in the city. And for this, the city was called the city of mosque. And of these mosques, the Shat Gumbuz Mosque was the most remarkable one. The mosque is unique in the sense that there are 60 pillars in the mosque, and these pillars support the roof with 77 low height domes. There are 4 towers at 4 corners of the mosque, and these 4 towers have 4 smaller domes on the top of it. You know, for ventilation and light, the mosque is provided with 25 arched doorways. Of them, 11 arched doorways are found at the eastern side of the mosque, and 7 is on the north and the south. So there are 25 arched doorways in the mosque. You know, there are 11 mihrabs. There are 11 mihrabs in the mosque, and the mihrabs are in the interior western wall of the mosque, and these mihrabs are pointing towards Mecca. And these mihrabs are decorated with terracotta. The mosque is built of brick and its floor is also made of bricks and the column is made of stone. You know, Khan Zahan Ali used this mosque as his prayer house, and he also used this mosque as a court. Now, this mosque is one of the best architectural beauties of Bangladesh, and it has become one of the greatest tourist attractions. Every day, many tourists come here to visit this mosque, and now it is a World Heritage Site. In 1985, UNESCO declared it a World Heritage Site. Okay, dear students, now I would like to introduce you to some new words, because in every lesson we get some new words. So now I would like to introduce you to some new words, that is new vocabularies. The first one, heritage. What is the meaning of heritage? Dear students, heritage means, heritage is what we inherit from the past, live with them at present, and then pass on to our future generation. So heritage means the traditions, achievements, beliefs, etc. that are a part of a nation. And the synonymous word of heritage is tradition or inheritance. Dear students, Shat Gumbuz Mosque is a heritage. Shat Gumbuz Mosque is a heritage. Next one, site. What is the meaning of the word site? Site means an area of ground on which a town, building or monument is constructed. Site means an area of ground on which a town, building or monument is constructed. Its synonymous word is a spot. Synonymous word is a spot. Shat Gumbuz Mosque is a World Heritage Site. Next one, outskirts. What is the meaning of the word outskirts? Outskirts means outer part of a town or a city. Outer part of a town or a city. Its synonymous word is edges. Shat Gumbuz Mosque is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town. Next, architecture. What is the meaning of the word architecture? Architecture means the art of designing and constructing building. Its synonymous word is design or building style. Design or building style. Next one, reservoir. What is the meaning of the word reservoir? Reservoir means a large lake used as a source of water supply. The lake may be natural or artificial. So, reservoir means a large lake used as a source of water supply. Its synonymous word is pool or water body. Next, aisle. What is the meaning of the word aisle? Aisle means a long narrow space. A long narrow space. Next one, cylinder. What is the meaning of the word cylinder? The column or the pillar of the mosque is cylinder. It's not so thick. So cylinder means slim or thin. Slim or thin. Dear students, now the word is terracotta. What is the meaning of the word terracotta? Terracotta means a hard brownish red earthen ware. A hard brownish red earthen ware. Its synonymous word is baked earth. The interior western wall of the mosque is beautifully decorated with terracotta flowers and foliage. Now, here is an activity for you. You have to make sentences using the following words. There are 8 words here, and you have to write 8 sentences using these words. So try yourself at home, and I think you will be able to write sentences using the words. Now, dear students, I am going to start reading the text. You have to follow me very carefully, because after reading the text, there are some activities and you will get all the necessary information of doing that activities here in this text. So while I will read the text, you will follow me very carefully, very attentively. Now I am going to start reading the text. Follow me, dear students. Heritage is what we inherit from the past, live with them in the present, and then pass on to our children or future generation. Our unique source of life and inspiration is our cultural and natural heritage. When we speak of world heritage, it indicates places and sites that we got from the past and pass on to the future generation of the interworld. The Shat Gumbuz Mosque in Bagerhat is such a heritage. It became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1985. Originally, the historic mosque city was known as Khalifatabad. It is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town, not very far from the dense mangrove forest of Sundarbans. Khalifatabad was a Muslim colony. It was founded by a Turkish general, Ulugh Khan Jahan Ali, a saint warrior Ulugh Khan Jahan, in the 15th century. The infrastructure of the city reveals significant technical skills in many mosques as well as early Islamic monuments. Baked bricks were used for the construction of the buildings. The planning of the city was distinctly dominated by Islamic architecture, and the decorations were a combination of the Mughal and Turkish architecture. Khan Jahan built a network of roads, bridges, public buildings and reservoirs to make the city habitable. There were about 360 mosques in the city. Among them, the most remarkable is the multi-domed Shat Gumbuz Mosque. The mosque is unique in the sense that it has 60 pillars that support the roof with 77 low-height domes. The four towers at four corners have smaller domes on the roof as well. The vast prayer hall has 11 arched doorways on the east and 7 east on the north and south for light and ventilation. It has 7 long aisles running along the length of the mosque and 11 deep carves between the cylinder stone columns. These columns support the carving arches created by the domes. The thickness of the arches is 6 feet and have slightly narrow, hollow and round wall. The west wall in the interior has 11 mihrabs. Mihrabs means niches in the mosque pointing towards Mecca. These mihrabs are decorated with stonework and terracotta. The floor of the mosque is made of bricks. Besides being used as prayer hall, Khan Jahan Ali used the mosque as his court too. Today, it is one of the greatest tourist attractions and one of the best architectural beauties of Bangladesh. Okay, dear students, now here is a chart for you. You have to complete the chart. There are two parts of the chart. At the left hand side, we can see some points are mentioned here, and the points are about Shat Gumbuz Mosque, and you have to complete the right hand side. The first one, founded by, that is, Shat Gumbuz Mosque was founded by. Who founded Shat Gumbuz Mosque? You have to complete the right side, providing the necessary information. By whom was the Shat Gumbuz Mosque founded? Next one, when, that is when was Shad Gumbuz Mosque founded. Third one, number of domes, that is how many domes are there in Shad Gumbuz Mosque. Number four, number of plots, you have to mention the number of plots of Shad Gumbuz Mosque. Number five, arches, how many arches are there in Shad Gumbuz Mosque. Next, thickness of the arches, what is the thickness of the arches, you have to write it at the right side. And last one, mihrabs, you have to write the number of mihrabs, how many mihrabs are there in Shad Gumbuz Mosque. Dear students, try yourself, you can take help of your text, you can take help from the text and you will find all the information in your text because everything is mentioned there. Try yourself. Now I will provide the answer and match your answer. Founded by, who founded Shad Gumbuz Mosque? You know, Ulugh Khan Jahan. Ulugh Khan Jahan founded Shad Gumbuz Mosque. Number two, when? When was the mosque founded? Khan Jahan Ali founded the mosque in the 15th century. Number three, number of domes. How many domes are there in the mosque? You have already learnt about it. There are 77 domes. How many domes are there? 77 domes. Number four, number of plots. How many plots are there in the mosque? There are 60 plots. There are 60 plots in the mosque. Number five, arches. How many arches do you find in Shad Gumbuz Mosque? There are 25 arches. In the text, we have seen that there are 11 arched doorways on the east and 7 east on the north and south. So, the total number of arches is 25. Thickness of the arches. What is the thickness of the arches? The arches are 6 feet in thickness. So, the thickness of the arches is 6 feet. Mihrabs. How many mihrabs? The number of mihrabs. How many mihrabs are there in Shad Gumbuz Mosque? There are 11 mihrabs. We can see 11 mihrabs in Shad Gumbuz Mosque. And the mihrabs are in the interior western wall of the mosque. And the mihrabs are beautifully decorated with terracotta. Okay, dear students, I think you have completed the chart with correct information. Now, you have another activity. Answer the following questions. Dear students, there are some questions here. You have to write down the answer of these questions. And you will also find the information necessary for writing the answer of this question in the text. So, take help from the text to write down the answer of this question. The first one is, what do you mean by heritage? Dear students, what do you mean by heritage? Heritage is what we inherit from the past, live with them at present, and then pass on to our children or future generation. And if I ask you, what is old heritage? Old heritage indicates places or site. Old heritage may be a place or may be a site that we got from the past and live on to our future generation of the entire world. Then it is called old heritage. Okay, dear students, next question, who founded a Muslim colony and when? You have already learnt it. Who founded a Muslim colony? You know, Ulugh Khan Jahan founded a Muslim colony. And when did he found it? He founded the Muslim colony in 15th century. You know, Khan Jahan came to Bagherhat in 15th century and he founded a nucleus of an affluent city and named it Khalifatabad. The former name of Bagerhat was Khalifatabad. Now it is known as Bagerhat. And Khan Jahan Ali founded this mosque in 15th century at Bagerhat. Then known as Khalifatabad. Third one, what did Khan Jahan Ali do to make the city habitable? You know, then Bagerhat was an inhospitable place. So Khan Jahan Ali had to do many things to make the city habitable. What did he do? He built a network of roads, bridges, public buildings and reservoirs to make the city habitable. He constructed reservoirs to remove the sufferings of pure drinking water of the local people. Next on, what does the infrastructure of the city reveal? The infrastructure means buildings, roads, bridges, etc. All are known as infrastructure. The infrastructure of the city reveals significant technical skills. And these skills are seen in many mosques and public buildings. Next on, do you think that Khan Jahan was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer? Hoy. Yes. I think you will agree with me. I think Khan Jahan was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer. He was great-hearted in this sense that he did many things for the well-being of his subjects. He constructed roads, bridges, public buildings, reservoirs, all he constructed for the well-being of the subjects. So we can say that he was a great-hearted Muslim colonizer. Dear students, here is a gap-filling activity for you. You have to fill in each gap with a suitable word on the information of the above text. That is, you will get all the information necessary for filling the gap in the text that we have already read. Now I am reading the text. You follow me. There are three odd heritage dash in Bangladesh. The Shat Gumbuz Mosque is one of them. The UNESCO dash it a odd heritage site in 1985. It is dash at the outskirts of Bagerhat town. It is an enormous Mughal architectural site dash a large area. Khan Jahan dash the mosque both as a prayer hall and a court. Dear students, try your best, and I think if you try, you will be able to write all the answers. Now match the answer. There are three World Heritage sites. In Bangladesh, there are three World Heritage sites. Here the right answer for gap number A is sites. Next one, the Shat Gumbuz Mosque is one of them. The UNESCO dash it. UNESCO declared it. The answer for gap number B is declared. Here the right word is declared. UNESCO declared it a World Heritage Site in 1985. It is at the outskirts of Bagerhat town. What is the right word here for gap number C? It is situated. Here right word is situated. It is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town. It is an enormous Mughal architectural site, dash a large area, covering a large area. Khan Jahan dash the mosque. Khan Jahan used the mosque. Here used is right word for gap number E. Khan Jahan used the mosque both as a prayer hall and a court. Okay, dear students, now write down your homework. Your homework is, you have to write 5 sentences mentioning the benevolent activities of Khan Jahan. What did Khan Jahan do for the well-being of his subjects, for the well-being of the people of Bagerhat? you have to write 5 sentences about it. So dear students, thank you for attending my class. Wish for the best.